Welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to cover DNS resolution and the features of Amazon Route 53. So Route 53 is a service that we can use for DNS resolution. We can create things called hosted zones. Now you can have public and private hosted zones. A private hosted zone is just for your internal VPC-based resources, whereas a public hosted zone can be used from the internet, so anyone can look up the DNS records that you're publishing. So here we might have a hosted zone called example.com, and we've got a couple of records in there. The hosted zone represents a set of DNS records belonging to a specific domain. So here, if somebody on the internet is looking for example.com, they will then get a result, and that result will then allow them to connect to that web service. And in this particular example, this is a public hosted zone. Now we can also have private hosted zones as well. So here we have mycompany.local, and here we have our instances and our database servers. And what we need to do is find out what the addresses are of those resources. So the private hosted zone gets associated with the VPC. We need to enable DNS hostnames and DNS resolution in the VPC settings. We then have records for our resources in the hosted zone. And in this example, the EC2 instance is able to look up the IP address of the database server. And that's an example of a private hosted zone. Route 53 is also an intelligent DNS service. We have things called routing policies. Routing policies determine which responses are provided to the client DNS resolver. For example, we can have a simple routing policy. There's nothing really special here. The DNS response will provide the IP address associated with a DNS name. We can have failover. With a failover, what's happening is if the primary record is down and Route 53 is able to do health checks against your service to check if it's accessible. And if it's not accessible, Route 53 will automatically provide a different address in DNS resolution requests. And that will be for your secondary. Geolocation uses the geographic location, so it determines where to route people based on where they are, so helping connect them to the closest region. Geoproximity gives you a bit more control and routes you to the closest region within a specific geographic area. Latency is where you're directed based on the lowest latency, which is typically means the resource that's closest to you. The farther you have to go, then the higher the latency. So to get low latency and better response times, you want to connect to resources that are closer to you. Multi-value answer will return several IP addresses and functions as a very basic load balancer. Finally, we have weighted. With a weighted routing policy, we assign relative weights. So we can configure it such that 80% of the clients will be sent to one resource, 20% to another. So if you're doing some kind of release testing, you can send a smaller portion of your clients to a different endpoint, and you can then sort of cut over to that or roll more traffic to that as you want to by assigning different weights. It's important to understand a few record types. Now, Route 53 supports lots of different record types, so I won't read through all of these in detail. However, it's worth pointing out the ones that are color-coded here. So the CNAME, the canonical name record, and the alias. Those are two that come up quite often in exam questions, and you have to understand some of the key differences between these two different record types. So let's go over that in more detail. So a CNAME record is a canonical name record, and that's where the resolver is resolving one domain name to another domain name. Now, Route 53 does charge for CNAME queries. Also, you can't create a CNAME record at the top of the DNS namespace. That's called the zone apex. So with the example.com example, you wouldn't be able to create a CNAME record for example.com that then maps to a different DNS domain name, because that's the zone apex. Now, if you had a subdomain of example.com, like dev.example.com, you could create a CNAME record for dev.example.com that corresponds to another DNS domain name. The CNAME record redirects queries for a domain name regardless of the record type, and you can point to any DNS record that's hosted anywhere. The record is visible in the answer section of a reply from the Route 53 DNS server. Now, with Alias records, Route 53 does not charge for Alias queries to AWS resources, but it's only actually supported for specific AWS resources. You can create an Alias record at the Zone Apex, but you can't create the CNAME at the Zone Apex. So it's really key to remember that. That's one of the main differences that you get tested on all the time. So back to our example, if you have the domain name example.com, that could be an Alias record from example.com that corresponds to a load balancer. So it would be the load balancer DNS name that then gets resolved, and then the IP address so you can connect to the load balancer nodes. Now, as I mentioned, there are specific resources that you can use an Alias with, such as CloudFront distributions, Elastic Beanstalk environments, load balancers, and S3 buckets that are configured as a static website.